Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the sixth video in the ADC series of the STM32. We have already covered how to read single channel and multiple channels of the ADC using all modes, that includes polling mode, interrupt mode, and the DMA mode. Today in this video we will understand the ADC sampling and conversion time. Basically we will first calculate the conversion time for the ADC channels, and then measure it on the scope. I will demonstrate the calculation and measurement as well. Also, we will test the timing in both F446RE and H750MCUs. Let's start the Cube IDE and create a new project. First, we will test the F446RE. Give some name to the project and click Finish. Let's start with the clock setup. Here we will bypass the high-speed clock source. The board has 8 MHz crystal, and we will run the system at maximum 180 MHz. Now let's go to ADC1, and enable channel 0. You can see the pin PA0 is selected as the ADC1 channel 0 pin. Let's configure the ADC clock first. As you can see in the clock configuration, we do not have a separate clock for the ADC. To understand where the ADC1 is getting the clock from, let's open the datasheet of the F446RE. Here you can find the clock information in this block diagram. As you can see here, the ADC1, 2 and 3, all are connected to the APB2 bus. As per our clock tree, the APB2 peripheral clock is at 90 MHz, and this is going to be the ADC clock itself. My scope will not be able to measure such a high frequency, so let me reduce the clock here. We can use the APB2 prescaler to reduce the clock. It is still high, let's reduce the system clock itself. Alright, now our APB2 clock is at 4 MHz. And so is the ADC1 clock. We can use the ADC prescaler to further reduce the peripheral clock. I am going to use the prescaler of 6. The ADC resolution is set to 12 bits. This resolution also plays an important role in determining the conversion time. We will cover that in a while. Let's enable the continuous conversion mode. We will also use the DMA, as we want the conversions to be as fast as possible. Let's enable the DMA in circular mode, and also make sure that the data width is set to half word. Now enable the DMA continuous request to make sure DMA keeps on transferring the data from the ADC. End of conversion flag is irrelevant, as we are using a single channel. Now let's configure the channel itself. Here I am setting the maximum sampling time, that is 480 cycles. Here we have the formula to calculate the sampling and conversion time. The sampling time only depends on the sampling cycles we set in the channel configuration. But this time is irrelevant, as it only includes the time ADC takes to sample the channel. The conversion time is more relevant to us, as this is the time when ADC delivers us the value itself. As you can see here, the conversion time depends on the sampling cycles we set, the conversion time, and the ADC clock. Here the conversion parameter depends on the resolution we set. To find the conversion time taken as per the resolution, you can check the reference manual of the MCU. Here I have the manual of the F446RE. Inside the ADC section, look in the fast conversion mode. Here you can see data for the minimum conversion time available for different resolutions. The value 3 is the minimum sampling cycle we can set. So for 12-bit resolution, the conversion parameter is 12, for 10-bit resolution, the parameter is 10, and similarly for 6-bit resolution, the parameter is 6. The Cube MX shows 15 clock cycles, for 12-bit resolution, and that is because it is showing the minimum conversion time we can get. as we have 3 clock cycles as the minimum sampling time we can set here. The conversion parameter may vary with different MCUs as well. Let's check the manual of the F103C8. The ADC resolution in F103C8 is fixed to 12 bits, and it can't be configured to something else. As you can see here, the conversion parameter for this 12-bit resolution is 12.5 cycles. Whereas in F446RE, the conversion parameter for 12-bit resolution was 12 cycles. The parameter varies in different MCUs, so make sure you check the reference manual of your controller. Alright, let's do the calculation now. I have set the sampling cycles to 480, the conversion parameter for 12-bit resolution is 12. Now the ADC clock, the 8PB2 clock is at 4 MHz, and we are using the prescaler of 6. So the ADC clock is 8PB2 clock divided by 6. This makes the conversion time equal to 738 microseconds. We will test it in the scope later. Let's set pin PA1 as output, as we will use this pin to measure the conversion time. Go to the GPIO configuration, and set the output speed of this pin to very high. Alright, that is all we need to configure. Click Save to generate the project. Let's define a 16-bit variable to save the ADC conversion data. Now in the main function, start the ADC in the DMA mode. We will store the value in the variable we just defined, and there is just one conversion. When the DMA finishes the transfer, an interrupt will trigger, and the conversion complete callback will be called. Inside this callback, we will toggle the pin PA1. Basically, this pin is being used to measure how frequently the conversion is complete, and the callback is called. That is all. Let's build and debug the project now. I am using the logic analyzer to measure the pin timing. Let's run the debugger, and also capture the data on the analyzer. Here you can see the pin remains high and low for 738 microseconds. This is exactly the same time that we calculated for the conversion to complete. So the conversion completes every 738 microseconds, the interrupt is triggered, and the pin toggles. Our calculation for the conversion time was very precise. Now onwards, I am going to modify this project in the CubeMX. Just for the demonstration, I am going to change the sampling cycles to 28 cycles. Let's modify the value in the formula 2. We got the conversion time of 60 microseconds now. Let's build the project and flash it to the board again. You can see the pin is now toggling every 60 microseconds. This means that the calculation is correct, and we are able to calculate the ADC conversion time. Let's try it for multiple channels now. Here I am enabling 3 more channels in the ADC configuration. Let's set the number of conversions to 4. The scan conversion mode is now enabled. End of conversion flag is set to the end of all channels. Let's configure the sampling time for all the channels. I am going to choose a different sampling time for each channel. This will result in different conversion times for each channel. We will add the conversion time for all the channels, and compare it with the result we get. The rest of the configuration is the same. Let's generate the project again. We will now calculate the conversion times for all the channels, and add them together. The only change is in the sampling cycles, the rest of the parameters in this calculation remain the same. The total conversion time is 1.176 milliseconds. Let's see if we get the same with our code. Since there are 4 channels now, let's define an array of 4 elements. Also inside the main function, change the data length to 4. That's all we need to modify. Let's build and flash the project to the board. Let's see the timing on the analyzer now. You can see the time is exactly the same as we calculated, that is 1.176 milliseconds. So the calculation works fine with multiple channels too. The similar calculation works for all the STM32 MCUs, but I found some discrepancy while testing the H7 series MCU. We will see it, so let's create a new project for the H750. I am using a H750VB based custom board, just like I used in the previous videos. Give some name to the project, and click Finish. I am going to start with the clock setup first. I am selecting the external crystal to provide the clock. The board has 25 MHz crystal, and we will run the system at maximum, 480 MHz. Let's enable channel 3 of ADC1 in the single-ended mode. Let's go back to the clock configuration. We need to modify the ADC clock source to bring the ADC clock in our measurable range. Alright, the ADC clock now is 2 MHz, and this should be fine for our measurement. Let's go back to the ADC configuration. I am setting the prescaler to 2, so this will bring the ADC clock down to 1 MHz. The resolution is set to 16 bits. Let's enable the continuous conversion mode. We also need to enable the DMA, so let's add it in the DMA section. Make sure the DMA is in the circular mode, and also the data width is set to half word. Now set the end of conversion to the end of the sequence, and also set the conversion data management to the circular DMA mode. Let's set the maximum sampling time for channel 3, that is 810.5 cycles. The pin PA6 is selected as the ADC1 channel 3 pin, although I am not connecting anything to the pin. Let's set the pin PD8 as output, so to measure the toggle time. Go to the GPIO configuration, and set the output speed to very high. Let's do the calculation for the conversion time now. We need to find the details about the conversion parameter, so let's check the reference manual of the MCU. Here, go to the ADC section, and you can find the details in the programmable resolution section. As mentioned here, for the 16-bit resolution, the conversion time is 8.5 ADC clock cycles. Let's put the values in our formula. We have selected 810.5 sampling cycles, 8.5 is the conversion parameter. The ADC clock is at 2 MHz, and we used a prescaler of 2. This will result in the total conversion time of 819 microseconds. Let's go back to the EE, and see if we get this time. The code will remain the same. We will first define a 16-bit variable to store the ADC data. Inside the main function, start the ADC in the DMA mode. Once the conversion is finished, an interrupt will trigger, and the conversion complete callback will be called. Inside the callback, we will toggle the pin PD8. That is all we need to program. Let's build and flash the project to the board. You can see the toggle time is 1.638 milliseconds. This is not what we got in the result. We should have got the time around 819 microseconds, but this is not the same as being shown in the scope. Now if we divide the ADC clock by 2, we will get 1.638 milliseconds. I tested this across different sampling times and resolutions, but this division parameter remained constant. After doing a lot of digging in the reference manual, I found out the reason for the same. To understand this division factor, go to the ADC Common Register section. Here, go to the Common Control Register. The bits 16 and 17 of the Common Control Register represents the clock mode. Under the clock mode, there are different sections for the devices with revision Y and with revision V. As per this statement, The ADC clock will have an additional divide factor of 2 for the devices with revision V. I have the MCU with revision V, and therefore this divide factor is applied to the ADC clock. Now what exactly is this revision V or revision Y? Here I have a picture showing the H750VB, and here you can see the letter V at the end, representing the revision V. Here is another picture of the same MCU, but with revision Y. So whether the divide factor will be applied or not, depends on the MCU revision you are using. As much as I have tested it, the same is valid for other H7 based MCUs as well. I have not tested the devices with revision Y, but as per the reference manual, they should not have this divide factor. If you guys have the H7 based MCUs with revision Y, please let me know the result in the comments below. Other than this divide factor, the rest of the things are just as we have seen in the F446. We got the ADC conversion time just as we calculated using the formula. This is it for the video. I hope you understood how to calculate the total conversion time for the ADC. You can download the project from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.